Video4. I'm such a blathermouth. My name again is Kelly Crow, and this is the fourth video for today showing you how I use scrapbooking to help document our homeschool life. If you've made it to the fourth video, I'm assuming you're at least interested in scrapbooking and maybe are looking at it as a hobby. And if you've watched this many, well, just bless your heart. Thanks for watching. I want to show you some resources because you might say, well, okay, if I'm going to get started, what do I need to do next? All right, if you are the type who needs a way to organize your photographs because they're in this huge box and you don't even know where to begin, this is a great resource. This book is called Photo Freedom by Stacy Julian. One of my all-time favorite scrapbookers is Allie Edwards. This has been a great book. I've read it over and over again. It's called Life Artist by Allie Edwards, and she has a lot of great ideas that I just wouldn't normally think of interesting ways to journal and interesting topics to journal about. Of course, magazines are a little bit cheaper than books, and there's quite a few magazines. If you're just getting started, I would actually suggest Simple Scrapbooks. They're easier to do pages, really eye-pleasing, graphic design-looking type of pages, and I really like this one a lot. Of course, there's also Scrapbooks Etc. and Creating Keepsakes magazines that have lots of really great ideas in them. Like another one that's good if you're just getting started is Designing with Simplicity. It's by Autumn Leaves. It's rather simple pages in interesting ways. If you are more artsy and kind of like experimenting with different paints and products and textures, Freestyle might be something that you're interested in. And then finally, these two books are actually going to be given away sometime during the conference. They're in the goodie bag. The Designing with Recipe book is really good. It's by Autumn Leaves. It's pretty new. If you have three photos that you want to scrapbook, you turn to chapter three. All the layouts in chapter three are three photo layouts. So it's pretty simple. That's the recipe you're following. And then Designing with Details, adding extra little details. For me, I like scrapbooking the same way that my mother loved cross stitch. And so I almost think of scrapbooking as kind of the new quilting, at least for me. All right, so those are some really great books. However, you don't have to have these books. These are great resources. Honestly, one of the best resources you already have. And it's magazines. There are certain magazines that appeal to you. There are certain ones that you already own, and there are certain ones you enjoy looking at again and again. And there's a reason, because the layout of them or the colors you like. I mean, it's probably good information on them too. All right, this one right here is just one from Atlanta Magazine that I really liked the layout. If I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 pictures and I need to figure out how to put them on a page, I might grab this piece of paper right here and go, hey, let me just copy what they've already done. Magazines employ graphic designers who have studied a long time on what makes pages look good. And you know what? I haven't studied at all. And sometimes I can't even explain why I like the way a certain page looks and why I don't like another one. However, the graphic designers probably could. The term for scrapbooking, when you copy somebody else's idea, is scraplifting or borrowing. It's a nice way of kind of just saying it's stealing, but here's another one. It's just a lot of pictures with the journaling in the middle. Another one I just really liked with the photographs at the top and plenty of room to write what they were about. And this would be for a page. It's pretty much just all pictures. So these are things you already have in your house. Quite often I will rip them out. Especially in the evening, if I'm just watching TV or something, or I don't really feel like scrapbooking, I'll rip them out and I'll cut them up and I'll just tape them, in not a very pretty way, inside this little book. And then when I need an idea later or I need some inspiration, I just open up this book and I flip right through it. And I've got probably 5 or 6 of these. And then my other great resource, which I mentioned before, was my calendar, which has the dates, the quotes, all the information I need to fill in the blanks with my journaling. For things I can't quite remember when it comes to scrapbooking. Like I said, you don't need all of this, it's just a resource depending on where your interests lie. Certainly don't get all caught up in buying all the supplies because it's really easy. However, the important thing is preserving the memories, and the supplies and the resources only should help you with that. They shouldn't dominate it and take over all your time. So those are my ideas for scrapbooking. I really hope that you've enjoyed this, and I hope you have a great rest of the conference. Thanks for watching.